X Nation. I'm Wackenstack. That's Breathing. And that's the X-Roid. That's what we're all waiting on. John's going to give us some rundown on the bow. Tell us what it is. So, John, let us have it.
Pretty much what we got is a 0708 PSC HF6 for baseline. HF cam, of course. Pretty much stock bow except for the limbs here. I did a little bit different specs on straightening the cables, not none drastic, but to get the draw length up for big whack here. Special order the limbs from TSC to get the weight we want, as you'll see in the picture we have here pretty soon. And basically, that's it. It's just a mean monster machine. It's ready to go, ready to shoot an elephant or whatever he wants to shoot with it.
That's an X-Force on steroids.
Yeah. That's how I got the name, the X-Roid. The idea came while I was in the tree stand, actually. Texting back and forth about numbers whack wanted to hit versus real life what we could do, and this bow just fit the bill perfect. So we ended up with the X-Roid. You can call it a 2012 X-Roid if you want to.
I like it. Custom features on the bow. We'll go over a couple of these while we're standing here. It looks like a regular quickie high rise, except it was built by hand, so it's kind of neat to me. The custom stab was built at Mountain Air Metalworks in Ripley, West Virginia. It's muzzle brake. A bow this bad needs a muzzle brake. And of course, it's got the whack logo on the front of it, so it's ready to whack something.
I've got all 24 strands, 452 X strands, which will be more than enough to plenty to hold this monster together. Performance numbers are just out of this world, ready to shoot through buildings, as you've seen before, I'm sure. So, it's ready to rock and roll.
Alright, let's do a little shooting.
Yeah.
Alright, because we had the shade reflecting off, this arrow comes in at 646 grains. You will see, we'll post the picture of what this shot through the chronograph. The conditions aren't right now, the lighting's not right.
Yeah, windy outside, cloudy, so.
So we'll post the picture. John shot this thing last, two nights ago and got the readings off of it, so we'll post it. But this is there, went through the chronograph at 646 grains. And you'll notice that we're inside and the bow's actually pretty quiet, so.
Specs on the bow is 31 inch draw on the money. I had to tweak a little bit just for whack because it's the way he anchors this special way. Fits him perfect.
So we shot this one, which you'll see the numbers, and the numbers are, came out to bear string at 331, right? So 331 feet a second with a 646 grain arrow. Someone was nice enough to stop by the shop with a 504 grain FMJ.
Yeah.
I happen to bring my own 504 grain arrow, and I'll let you hear this one go through the bow. And, at 504 grains, it shot it at 364.8 feet a second. So 365 at 504 grains. Hey, bow shoots like a dream, I'll tell you. I mean, I know it's hard to do a bow review for a bow that so few people are ever going to want to own. But just like every other X-Force bow, pulls nice and smooth. Smooth transition into the valley, holds solid. I've shot it now, down here 40 times, maybe. And it feels great. It feels like I've been shooting it for a year already. So, really liking it. Can't wait to get it out and actually get to do some testing with it and getting used to trying to bust knocks with the thing. Couple things to point out. Obviously, Breathing did the bow. One Stringer did all the decals for it. Same did the hood decals, the decals for the stab. They did the wraps on the bow, which are custom with the whack logo and the X-Roid on them over top of diamond plate, which I thought was fitting. The limb decals, I forgot the acetone remover so we could stick the limb decals on. The stock PSC ones were on it. They did the limb decals, which has the John's Custom Archery with the John's logo and then the PSC X-Roid. So, those will go on the bow when we get back to West Virginia. I'm a badass, and you don't want to clap, 'cause your mouth white, that's just your face.